Hello everyone, I'm Sengoku Freak, and today I would like to make a Pokemon challenge video. I got this idea after watching a couple of the challenges that Michael from MNJ TV did, and I was interested to do so. I wanted to do a catchless run of Pokemon Fire Red, a game I haven't played in a very long time. This run was inspired by Plonkerboy's 900's video of the same run, but I would like to try it out for myself. Links to their channels in the description below. So, what's a catchless run, you may ask? Well, here are the rules. I'm not allowed to catch any Pokemon and use them in battle. Gift Pokemon are fair game as long as I don't catch them. I can only catch Pokemon if, and only if, they will be used as HM Mules, or slaves. Because the early gen games are notorious for heavily relying on HMs, and I don't want to waste valuable space for these. So, a mule is where this is needed. Name every gift Pokemon you get, because nicknaming them is fun, so why not? Oh, and I guess items are okay in battle, just to see how it'll turn out, because this is my first challenge, so let's see how it goes. It's true that it feels like an easy challenge. I just want to try out something fair and simple for me to get the hang of Pokemon challenges, and who knows, I might actually make more difficult runs later on. Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe to watch me suffer in future challenges. First off, we need to decide the name for the character. I went with Sen, since it's short for Sengoku, and for the rival, I think he needs a name that fits him perfectly. He is known as the douchebag rival, and we all love to hate him. So, Cunt with a K it is. I started the journey and chose Bulbasaur, nicknamed Gamabunta, because it reminded me of the giant toad summon in Naruto. Yes, I'm a weeb, it comes with the title. And set out on my journey. Got killed twice in Route 1. Oh god. We are off to a good start. Soared Viridian Forest, which was uneventful, learned Vine Whip on the way. Headed to the first gym. One hit KO'd everything in sight before fighting off Brock. Gamabunta took care of both of his Pokemon without issues and nabbed the first badge. Gamabunta evolved to Ivysaur in the process. I removed Tackle by mistake for Sleep Powder. You'll know why. On our way to Mount Moon, I bought the Magikarp and nicknamed her Siriu. After acquiring Siriu, I entered Mount Moon. Didn't fight all the trainers because it felt pointless. Bunta is already overleveled, so I just plowed through the cave. As I reached the Maniac, a Team Rocket grunt stopped me. His Rattata didn't cause any challenge, but his Zubat was the issue. I forgot to check on Gamabunta's attack PPs because they were all finished and was killed off by the Zubat. And because of my mistake of removing Tackle, my other attacking move, I lost the fight. Fucking Zubats! Not a good start for this challenge. Thank God it's not a Nuzlocke. I leveled up Bunta and switched Vine Whip with Razor Leaf. I defeated the Grunt and challenged the Maniac for our future teammate. I didn't know who to choose since both are the same type and are really good. So I'm really having a hard...
Nani? Dorime. Interimo adapare Dorime. Ameno, ameno.
Chose the Lord to join me. I was able to get out of the dreaded Mount Moon. Grinded the team just to be sure to take on Misty. I one-shotted the gym trainers. Again, no issues, just plowing through. Then I started fighting Misty. I started out with Siriu for it to get the XP. Switched it back to Bunta to tank out the hits from Staryu. I'm not worried since first, I'm overleveled. Second, nothing that Staryu will attack me with will cause a dent to Buntet. Good thing he started out with Harden instead of attacking. My Razor Leaf misses, but thankfully Staryu hardens again. My second Razor Leaf lands and crit one hit kills Staryu. There she sends out Starmie. Again, I send out Siryu for the XP and change back to Bunta. Starmie used Water Pulse and only chipped off so little of Bunta's HP. Starmie was faster than Bunta and landed a Swift, but one more Razor Leaf for it to reach the heal range. She healed and two more Razor Leaves for the kill. Got the second badge without any issues. Had a little friendly chat with Cunt. By friendly, I meant wiping the fucking floor with his face. He started out with Pidgeotto, and I with Siryu. Switched back to Bunta to tank off his hits, he sand attacked me instead. I crit Razor Leaf to killing range, and next turn, he sand attacked me again, one more Razor Leaf to kill him off for good. He sent out his Charmander, and I switched out to Siryu for the sweet EXP. I chipped some HP before sending out Bunta. After a couple of turns, the Charmander is down and Bunta was burned a couple of turns back. He sent out his Abra. I decided to keep Bunta and heal this time since Abra has no way of hitting me, for he only has teleport at this point. I also threw Leech Seed to speed up the healing process, as well as damaging the Abra. He instead got killed by one Razor Leaf and I needed to switch to Siryu for now. He sends out his last Pokemon, a Rattata. I started with Tackle and he retaliates with a crit Tackle. I decided to let Siryu faint for now if it means I can heal Bunta and go for the kill. And that is exactly what happened. I defeated Cunt yet again. On the way to Bills' house, I got defeated by a fucking Oddish. Of course, I spent all of my Razor Leaf PP and was stuck with non-damaging moves. The stupid thing kept using Absorb and Sweet Scent until all of my team fainted. After defeating the Oddish, it's weird that I'm having issues with weak early game Pokemon and not gym battles. Never mind. I was able to evolve Siryu to Gyarados. Oh, let the shenanigans begin. Also caught a fucking Oddish for HM Mules. Rule still apply since I will not use him in battle and only to progress to the game. I taught Gyarados Water Pulse for Stab. I decided to change Bunta's Sleep Powder for Secret Power TM, a normal type attack that has secondary effects depending on the terrain. After getting the SS ticket, I made my way to Vermilion City and aboarded the ship. The ship was uneventful until I met up with Cunt and was challenged to a battle. We just kicked your ass like 10 minutes ago! He sends out his Pidgeotto and I send out my Siryu. It's really fun having an overpowered Pokemon this early in the game. Two Water Pulses and he's down. He then sends out Raticate, a couple of bites, and there goes his second Pokemon. He sends out his Kadabra and I send out Gamabunta this time. Two Razor Leaves and he's gone. I switched out to Siryu and he sends out his final Pokemon, Charmeleon. Two Water Pulses were needed to finish off the battle as he was 1 HP away from 1-hit KO. We defeated Cunt yet again. I obtained HM Cut and teach it to my mule to be able to enter the Vermilion City Gym. Okay, here is where we will have an issue. The first two gyms were a cakewalk since I was super effective on them. But here, not only do I not have a super effective Pokemon against Lieutenant Surge, Siryu is 4 times weak to Electric, so I need to tread very carefully when going against him. Lieutenant Surge started out with Voltorb. I was able to deal with him with 2 secret powers. He sends out his Pikachu, which was 1-hit KO'd by Bunta. He then sends out his Raichu. I decided to go with Razor Leaf, so if the secret power did not 1-hit KO him, he will not be in healing range. He paralyzed Bunta and I decided to end him off with Razor Leaf seeing that his health was in killing range. I defeated Lieutenant Surge with flying colors. This resulted in Gamabunta evolving to Venusaur. Now, two of my teammates are fully evolved. He gives me the TM Shockwave and I head east to my next destination, Lavender Town. But Before we head there, we need to tread all the way back to get our new teammate, an old amber, which will give us an Aerodactyl later on, since we have access to cut. We head to Route 9, where it's mostly uneventful, until reaching our next stop, the Rock Tunnel. This place is really annoying. The cave is dark and you need to use HM Flash to easily get through it. But the problem is, for you to get Flash, you need to catch a certain number of Pokemon, and then one of the professor's aides will give you the HM. Since this is a catchless challenge, in a sense, I'm not able to get the Flash. So, I will have to navigate this cave in the dark. I used a guide to get past the cave. Sue me! And was able to reach Lavender Town. As soon as we reach Lavender Town, I head west to Celadon City to get the third member of the team, an Eevee named Renamon. Because, you know, he looks like Renamon from Digimon. With the yellow fur and the spikes. Yeah, you get it. I bought a Thunderstone and evolved him to Jolteon. Taught him the shockwave that we got from a talent surge. Before fighting Erica, we need to get another teammate in Saffron City. By bribing the guards with some tea, we now have access to Saffron City and our traversal will be smoother from now on. We head to the fighting dojo to get our new member. Yikes! They are overleveled. But we shouldn't have any issues, right? We defeated the dojo trainers with one of our teammates, Renamon, fainted, and only Black Belt Koichi is left. He sends out Hitmonlee, and I send out Bunta. I start out with Razor Leaf, which didn't do much damage. His high jump kick didn't either, but it was worrying since Bunta is my strongest Pokemon so far, and I can't put a dent on him. I decided to go with Secret Power, which did a better amount of damage, but his kicks brought Bunta to killing range. Luckily, I was faster and killed him off first. He sends out his Hitmonchan. I went with Secret Power, which didn't do enough damage. He used Fire Punch and almost killed me. Seeing that he had Fire Punch means that he would have the other elemental punches, and I needed to stall. I send out Siryu to decrease his attack using Intimidate, and the fucker read my play with his 200 IQ and landed a Thunder Punch! It didn't do that much damage, thank God! I decided to chip damage and stall, but he was able to kill off Siryu before me healing Bunta. Now I'm stuck. I didn't realize I had a Hyper Potion in my bag and used it on Bunta, and now we are back to full health. Only for him to use an Ice Punch, and then which led to Bunta getting frozen! What the hell is with this guy's luck?! Seeing that I didn't buy Ice Heals, cause I didn't think I would be frozen at this point in time, I can't do anything until Bunta was defrosted. I used this chance to revive my teammates just in case it takes a turn for the worse. After 5 turns, I was defrosted and was able to defeat the Hitmonchan. We now have our fourth member of the group, a Hitmonchan named Ippo. After the boxing anime, Hajime no Ippo. I didn't watch it, so I don't know what the characters are called, so Ippo is the choice for it. I grinded both Ippo and Renamon for them to learn the elemental punches and pin missile respectively. Now it's time to face off Erica. It was interesting. We started the battle with Erica, she sends out her victory bell and I sent out Ippo. I landed a fire punch and she missed a stun spore. I thought a frozen effect would be nice to land on her with an ice punch, but it didn't. However, it did give her a nice damage for her to be in killing range. She then stunned Ippo and healed before I get to kill her. She giga drained and I kept getting paralyzed, and then she kept spamming acid until Ippo is down. I went with Renamon and shockwaved, and one quick attack later, she is gone, not before stunning Renamon. She sends out Tangela, or as I like to call him, Satan's pubic hair. I went and revived Ippo, because I need good super effective attacks against this thing. And that gave her an opportunity to set up Ingrain, a very stupid move on my part. The stupid thing kept Giga Draining and healing from Ingrain, and I can't, for the life of me, stop it from healing. I sent out Ippo, hoping to freeze or burn her. Thankfully, after a couple of fire punches and a sky upper attack, I got rid of that shit. In goes Vileplume. I misclicked on a sky uppercut and did some good damage. Good thing she missed the stun spore. I fire punched and she stuns me. She Giga Drained. Luckily, it wasn't too much of a struggle for me to kill her off with the next fire punch. The fourth gym battle was over. I am rewarded with Giga Drain and I teach it to Bunta right away. I head to Team Rocket's hideout using Renamon to decimate all of the grunts and made my way to Giovanni. Siryu sweeped both his Onix and Rhyhorn with Water Pulse and Ippo one-hit KO'd Kangaskhan with Sky Uppercut. We defeated Giovanni and got the Sylph Scope. We returned back to Lavender Town and entered the Pokemon Tower. We saw Cunt again and was challenged to a battle. Renamon killed three of his team without a hitch. Nice! And we wiped the floor with him yet again. We make our way to the top of the tower, killing the vengeful Gen 1 Mother Spirit Marowak, and saved Mr. Fuji and was rewarded with the Pokeflute. We make our way to the west of Celadon City to wake up the Snorlax, only to run away. Didn't feel like finding it. Also, what's the point to fight it if I'm not gonna catch it? We head inside, only to forget to get the bike. Okay, go back to Vermilion City, get the voucher, and then back to Cerulean City for the bike. Then, get the HM Fly just in case before heading to Fushisa City. I caught a Pidgey for my Fly Mule. I reached there to face off Koga. I sent out Siryu against his coughing, Hydro Pump one-hit KO'd it, and I switched to Renamon for his Muk. I was faster than the Muk, so took care of him after three shockwaves. Renamon one-hit kills coughing with a shockwave. This thing is unstoppable! His wheezing proved to be a pain, killing Renamon and fully healing, but Siryu came to the rescue and finished the job with two Hydro Pumps, getting us the fifth badge. We entered the Safari Zone to get HM Surf, and we forgot to get the Golden Teeth for strength. I'll worry about that later. I taught Surf for Siryu in place of Water Pulse. Thank you, Water Pulse. You have served your purpose. We make our way back to Saffron City to head to the Sylph Corps headquarters to get our new member. We made our way to Cunt, where we fight him again. Renamon annihilated most of his team on his own, and Ippo took out the Execute, finishing off Cunt. We then get our new team member, a Lapras we called Issei, based off the Japanese Loch Ness Monster. I'm really running out of names here. We face off against Giovanni once again. Siryu took care of half of his team, and Ippo took care of the Khan. Giovanni sent out his Nidoqueen, and Ippo finally froze somebody with an Ice Punch. I switched back to Siryu for the kill. We freed the building from Team Rocket, and the chairman gifted us with a Master Ball, the most useless item in this run for me. We head off to fight Sabrina. Okay, I guess almost all of you who played the Gen 1 games can agree with me that Sabrina is bullshit. The psychic typing was completely OP in Gen 1, and even after the dark typing and the bug fixes, Psychic is still a very powerful typing, and I need to be very careful when going against her. Is what I would be saying if Renamon didn't wipe the fucking floor with her team. Seriously, Pin Missile is a godsend. I defeated her and got my sixth gym. I used my Fly Mule to travel back to Pallet Town and served south to Cinnabar Island. Our first stop is to get the last remaining team members, the Fossils, Ammonite named The Lord, and an Aerodactyl named Silver Rathalos. But I need to remove a member for the team to add the Fossils. I decided to send Siryu to the PC for her retirement. She was a fine companion, and for that, you shall be missed.
これから何が起こっても左腕のこれが仲間の印だ。
We head to the Pokemon Mansion to unlock the gym as well as leveling up the new teammates. The Lord evolved to Omnistar. Now our team is fully evolved. Before finishing the task, I decided to teach Raphael's fly and head back to the rock tunnel. Let me explain. Inside the rock tunnel is a person that teaches the move Rock Slide, a very good rock physical attack to Rathalos. I teach it to him and head back to the mansion. We find the key and head over to Blaine. Okay, so before I blab on what happened with Blaine, let me say one thing. I have three Pokemon that are strong against him at this moment, and my team is fully prepared for Giovanni. So what do you think will happen? Surf's up, dude! Issei proved her might with Blaine, where she single-handedly beat him with only Surf. I defeated him, and he gave me TM Fire Blast and set my eyes for Giovanni, the last gym leader. Same thing happened with Blaine. Issei really took care of him and his team with just Surf. Now, I have all of the gym badges and ready to face off the Elite Four. Giovanni gives me Earthquake and I teach it to Bunta, replacing Secret Power. I chose to give it to Bunta for one reason. When was the last time I used Bunta in a major fight? Exactly. If you haven't noticed, the last major fight was in the Fighting Dojo with Hitmonchan. After that, the team became more viable for the remainder of the battles till now that I barely use him. I just grinded him up just to be even leveled for the rest of the team. He deserves this rest and this earthquake. We fight our rival Cunt one last time before heading to the Victory Road. We embark on Victory Road and we saw this. Oh yeah. I forgot about the HM strength. Fuck! We head back to the Safari Zone, find the Golden Teeth, and get the HM. I gave it to Rathalos in replace of Ancient Power, since it's a special attack and he is a physical attacker. We make our way to the Victory Road and inside the Indigo Plateau. Before fighting the Elite Four, I removed the HM Strength and replaced it with Fire Blast for Rathalos, and decided to grind up the team one last time before fighting the Elite Four. Here is my final team setup before the league. Renamon, the Jolteon with Thunder, Shockwave, Double Kick, and Pin Missile. Gamabunta, the Venusaur with Earthquake, Poison Powder, Giga Drain, and Razor Leaf. The Lord, the Omnistar, with Mudshot, Surf, Rock Tomb, and Bite. Issei, the Lapras with Ice Beam, Body Slam, Psychic, and Surf. Silver Rathalos, the Aerodactyl with Fly, Rock Slide, Bite, and Fire Blast. And lastly, Ippo, the Hitmonchan with the Elemental Punches, Fire, Thunder, and Ice Punches with Brick Break. Our first fight was with Lorelei. She sends out her Dewgong and I send out Renamon. I decided to stock up on Thunder and chose Shockwave since Renamon can easily defeat her team. Her Ice Beam crit froze Renamon. And I decided to full restore, and she goes for another Ice Beam. One more Shockwave took it down. The next is Cloyster. I used Thunder on her, and boy did it fry that clam good. Next is Slowbro. I felt a little greedy with Thunder, which missed, which landed a Yawn on me. The second Thunder landed, and one-hit KO'd Slowbro. Next is Lapras. I switched Renamon for Ippo to negate the sleep. Thunder Punch didn't do shit to Lapras, and it finally dawned on me. Hitmonchan is versatile, but his elemental punches don't do shit. I decided to use Brick Break that did the needed damage. Lapras used a Citrus Berry that healed her just enough that she doesn't enter the healing range. One more Brick Break, and the Lapras is gone. Finally is her Jinx. I went for Pin Missile, which landed two hits, and goes for Lovely Kiss, which sleeps Renamon. I healed, and then she Ice Punched me. I miss out a Thunder, and she sleeps me again! I misclicked, and she Ice Punched me to death. I sent out the Lord. She misses the Kiss, and Bite lands a nice blow on her. Sadly, she healed up the following turn, but I used Rock Tomb to lower her speed, which did an amazing amount of damage. Finally, I use Bite for the kill. One down, four to go. Next is Bruno. He sends out his Onyx, and I brought the Lord. The Lord tanked two earthquakes and was able to kill off the two Onyxes. The Lord works in mysterious ways. Next is Hitmonchan.
Nom flashbacks.
I went with Issei to deal with him with Psychic, which did half of his HP, but so did his Sky Uppercut. One more Psychic and he's done. Next is Hitmonlee. I thought I can hit him with Psychic, but he was faster than me and killed Issei. I send out Rathalos. I use Fly and one hit killed him for the revenge kill. Lastly is his Machamp. I did the same strat of flying to waste his turns, which worked. I was able to kill him off before the bulk up went anywhere. Machamp is down for the count, and I defeated Bruno. Next is
Agatha.
The most annoying one so far. She sends out her Gengar, and I send out Issei. She went for not one, not two, not three, but four double teams! And I missed the first three! The fourth one finally lands a hit. I knew that she will heal this bitch, so I decided to go with Ice Beam that crits one hit KO'd the Gengar. Ooh, sweet, sweet justice. Renamon was able to dispose the Golbat no problem, not before landing a poison on Renamon. Next is the Arbok. I send out Issei. The Arbok poisoned me first, and I was able to finish it off with a Surf. Next is the second Gengar. I send out the Lord. He hypnotized me first and continued with Shadow Ball. But the Lord woke up immediately and landed a hit. Praise Helix! Lastly is her Haunter. He failed the hypnosis. The Lord will not fall for the same trickery twice. And almost killed it off. The Haunter healed and repeated the hypnosis shtick again and failed, landing the finishing blow. Agatha is defeated, and two more remaining. Lan sends out his Gyarados, and I send out my Renamon. You know what's about to happen. If your answer was a Shockwave one-hit KO'd the Gyarados, then you're correct. He sends out a Dragonair, the first dragon Pokemon in this run, only for it to die the second it landed on the field with Issei's Ice Beam. He sends out his Aerodactyl, and I tank an Ancient Power. See? That's why I removed it. It's a special attack. You're supposed to go with physical. Anyway, I go with a Surf and barely kill it off for it to heal the next turn. Two more Surfs and the Aerodactyl is no more. He sent out the second Dragonair. Like his brother before him, he too died the second he came onto the field with the Ice Beam. Lastly is his Dragonite. I got a little cocky and thought it one more Ice Beam would do the trick, but he was faster than me and used a Hyper Beam and killed off Issei. It's weird he chose a Hyper Beam, he's completely vulnerable. I send out Rathalos to kill him off, he survived two Rock Slide, and one hit kills Rathalos with an Outrage. No wonder you're a bitch to deal with. I send out Ippo to finish the job. The Dragon Tamer is defeated, and then there's one. Our last battle for the run is the Pokemon champion, Cunt. He sent his Pidgeot and I sent my Renamon. He's easily defeated by Renamon. Deja vu. He sends his Rhydon and I misclicked, so Renamon was still on the field. I switched it to Gamabunta. Hello, old friend. And took the earthquake head on. One Razor Leaf and he's down. Just like old times. He sent out his Alakazam, I send out Renamon. Pin Missile only did little damage, but he crits one-hit KO'd Renamon with Psychic. I was surprised and worried that Alakazam would be a huge threat. I send out the Lord to deal with him and finish him off with two bites, not before setting a Reflect on the field. He sends his Exeggutor and I send in Issei. Ice Beam barely kills him and he sets up a Sleep Powder. I thought I might be lucky to wake up the next turn, but no. Good thing the Reflect wore off. He set up Light Screen before I could wake up and Body Slam him, which paralyzes him, but he was Giga Draining a lot, that I took this chance to chip some damage and let Issei die off for my next Pokemon to take the kill. I sent out Rathalos and used Fly on him. He immediately used Sleep Powder on Rathalos. We both used this turn to heal up. Rathalos used Fire Blast twice for the kill. He sends his Gyarados and I sent out Ippo this time to hit him with a Thunder Punch. It didn't do much damage and decided the next course of action is to heal Renamon. He took two thrashes like a champ for me to heal Renamon. As soon as I sent Renamon, his Gyarados got confused because of the thrash, and I wanted to cheese it with Thunder only for me to miss. But what's good is that he hit himself with confusion. One Shockwave later and the Gyarados is fried. Lastly was his starter, Charizard. I decided to keep Renamon and try to cheese it one more time with Thunder, and then the unthinkable happened. The Thunder lands and one-hit KOs the Charizard before he gets to do anything. To be honest, this was a first for me. I was shocked, pun not intended. Seeing him getting killed on the first turn he sent out really feels good. And with that, I have defeated Cunt once and for all and became the new Pokemon League champion without using any caught Pokemon. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you want me to try out any other Pokemon challenges, make sure you write it down in the comments and put a like on this video. Also, make sure to subscribe to my friend DarkRyQ8 for more Pokemon related videos. And also, make sure to follow MNJTV as well as PlonkerBoy900 for inspiring me to make this video. Until then, I'll see you all later.